बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। सो आवर टुडेज लेक्चर इज एंगुलर एंड प्रांटल सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट थ्री सिस्टम्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन, दैट इज आर्टिफिशियल क्लासिफिकेशन, नेचुरल क्लासिफिकेशन एंड फाइलोजेनेटिक क्लासिफिकेशन। इन आर्टिफिशियल क्लासिफिकेशन इट इज द ओल्डेस्ट एंड फर्स्ट अप्रोच ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स, बट इट कैन नॉट डिस्क्राइब ऑल द प्लांट्स। And artificial system of classification is based upon one or few characteristics of plant which is selected by the authors. I repeat, artificial classification of system is based upon the characteristics of the plants which is selected by the author, such as the reproductive characters, its physical appearance of the plant, habitat of the plant, phenology, cotyledons, etc. The natural system of classification of plant is the second system of classification of plant, which is based upon the natural affinities of the plant, and it involves the maximum natural characteristics of the plants. Whereas the third classification system of plant is the phylogenetic classification system. It is the latest system of classification of plant. And in this system of classification, plants have been classified according to their evolutionary relationship. So today we will study the angular and prandtl system of classification, which is an example of phylogenetic classification of plants. Adolf Engler and Karl Prandtl are two German botanists. They proposed the classification system of plant based on their evolutionary relationships. They described about 303 plant families depending on their evolutionary relationships, and they described them in a book which is known as Die Naturreichen Plants and Familien of Angiosperms. In this book they have published its 23 volumes, and in this book they have described about 303 flowering plants. Adolf Engler and Karl Prandtl are two German botanists. They have published a book, Die Naturreichen Plants and Familien of Angiosperm. They published 23 volumes of this book, and in this book they have described 303 flowering plant families based on the evolutionary relationships of plants. Starting the outline and basis of classification of Engler and Prandtl's classification system, the plant kingdom or the plants identified at that time were divided into 13 divisions. The division 1 to 12 dealt with bacteria, algae, fungi, bryophytes and tritophytes. Okay, whereas the 13th division is named as embryophyta or siphonogamia. This embryophyta or siphonogamia includes all the seed producing plants. This is the basic outline of Engler and Prandtl's classification system, in which plant kingdom is divided into two divisions. Division 1 to 12 consists of bacteria and algae, fungi and the lower plants, bryophytes and tritophytes, whereas the 13th division comprises of embryophyta. This embryophyta comprises of all the plants which produce seed, which contain seeds. Then the embryophytes are divided into two subdivisions, and these subdivisions are gymnospermy and angiospermy. The seeded plants are divided into two subdivisions, gymnospermy and angiospermy. So what are the gymnosperms? Gymnosperms are the flowerless plants that produce cones and seeds. Gymnospermy include all the gymnosperms which are flowerless plants and they produce cones and seeds, and these seeds are not enclosed in ovary. Whereas angiospermy consists of angiospermic plants, which are the vascular plants, and these in angiosperms produce flowers and their seeds are enclosed within the ovary. So plant kingdom has been divided into 13 divisions. 1 to 12 consists of bacteria, algae, fungi, bryophytes and pteridophytes, whereas the 13th division, embryophyta, consists of the seeded plants. These seeded plants are further divided into two subdivisions, that is gymnospermy and angiospermy. Gymnospermy include the gymnosperms, which are the flowerless plants, and their seeds are not enclosed in ovary, their seeds are naked, okay? Whereas the angiospermy consists of the angiosperms, which are flowering plants, and their seeds are enclosed in an ovary. Now the angiospermy has been divided into two classes. These classes are monocotyledony and dicotyledony. Angiospermy is basically divided on the basis of number of cotyledons into two classes, that is monocotyledony and dicotyledony. So what is the cotyledon? Cotyledon is actually the part of the embryo within the seed of a plant. Cotyledon is a part of the embryo within the seed of the plant, and it can be defined as the embryonic leaf in seed-bearing plants. Cotyledon is basically the part of the embryo within the seed of the plant, and it is defined as the embryonic leaf in seed-bearing plants. So monocotyledony, mono means one, and cotyledony mean cotyledon. Monocotyledony contains one cotyledon, and dicotyledony, di means two, and cotyledony mean cotyledons. Dicotyledony consists of two cotyledons, okay? So further, dicotyledony has been divided into two subclasses, that is archiclimati and metaclimati. Archiclimati and metaclimati have been divided into these subclasses on the basis of flowering parts, that is petals. In archiclimati, the petals of the flowers are absent or they are separate or free. Dicotyledony has been divided into two subclasses on the basis of flowering parts, that is petals, archiclimati and metaclimati. Archiclimati consists of those plants in which the petals of the flowers are free, separate or absent, while that of metaclimati is a group of plants in which the petals of the flowers are united. So dicotyledony has been divided into two subclasses, archiclimati and metaclimati, on the basis of the fusion and separation of petals. So archiclimati consists of those plants which have free petals, separate petals, or petals are absent in this subclass, whereas metaclimati is the class where petals are fused. So once again, revising all that, plant kingdom has been divided into 13 divisions by Engler and Prandtl based on their evolutionary relationships. Out of these 13 divisions, 1 to 12 include bacteria, algae, fungi, bryophytes and pteridophytes, whereas that of 13 consists of embryophyta, which are the seed-producing plants. Embryophyta or seed-producing plants are further divided into two subdivisions, gymnospermy and angiospermy. Gymnospermy consists of gymnosperms, which are flowerless plants and their seeds are naked, whereas angiospermy consists of angiosperms or flowering plants in which seeds are enclosed in an ovary. Angiospermy is further divided into two classes based on number of cotyledons. These two classes include the monocotyledony and dicotyledony. The class monocotyledony consists of one cotyledon, whereas dicotyledony consists of two cotyledons. Then the class dicotyledony has been divided on the basis of flowering parts, that is petals characters, into two subclasses, archiclimati and metaclimati. Archiclimati consists of those plants in which petals are free, separate or absent, while metaclimati consists of those plants in which petals are fused. So this is the classification of the angiosperms. While moving towards the gymnosperms, Engler and Prandtl, on the basis of evolutionary relationships, divided the gymnosperms into 7 orders. These 7 orders include, number 1, cycadophelicales. The cycadophelicales consists of an extinct order of gymnosperms which become extinct today. Cycadales is the second order. Cycadale is an order of seed plants that include all the extant cycads. It includes all the cycads. Number 3 is the Benetetales. The Benetetales is an extinct order of seed plant that first appeared in the Permian period and became extinct in most areas toward. So Cycadophelicales and Benetetales, both orders consist of plants which become extinct today. Cycadales consists of the extant cycads. Fourth one is Gingkogales. The Gingkogales is a gymnosperm order which consists of only one species. It is a monotypic order. Monotypic means it consists of only one species, one type genus, that is Gingko, and the species which is known as Gingko biloba. So Gingkogales is order of gymnosperm which consists of only one species. So it is also known as a monotypic order. It consists of only one type genus, that is Gingkos, and its species Gingko biloba. Fifth order is Coniferales. Coniferales consists of plants that reproduce with cones or related structures. All the plants in the gymnosperms that reproduce with the cones or related structures is included in Coniferales. Sixth one is Chordates. Chordates is also an extinct order of woody plants that may consist of the early conifers, but this order is the extinct. And the seventh one is Nettles. The Nettles consists of the most advanced gymnosperm, which is the Neetum. Neetum is the genus from which its scientists thought that all the angiosperms evolved. So Nettles is believed by some botanists to be the ancestor of flowering plants or angiosperms, and it is highly evolved genus of the gymnosperm. So gymnosperms are divided into 7 orders: Cycadophelicales, Benetetales, and Chordates. These 3 orders are now consists of extinct species which are now extinct, whereas Cycadales consists of cycads, Gingkogales consists of Gingko, and it is a monotypic order, that is, it consists of only one genus, which is Gingko, and a species, that is Gingko biloba. Coniferales include the conifers of the plant which reproduce by cones or cone-like structures, and Nettles is treated to be the most advanced order in case of gymnosperm. So, outline of Engler and Prandtl's classification: plant kingdom divided into 13 divisions. 1 to 12 consists of bacteria, algae, fungi, bryophytes, stridophytes. 13 consists of embryophyta, which are the seeded plants. Seeded plants are divided into 2 subdivisions, gymnospermy and angiospermy. Gymnospermy are the flowerless plants. Angiospermy are flowering plants. Gymnospermy consists of seeds which are naked. Angiosperm consists of seeds which are enclosed in an ovary. Angiospermy is further divided into 2 classes based on the number of cotyledons, into monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Monocotyledons consists of 1 cotyledon, whereas dicotyledons consists of 2 cotyledons. Dicotyledons are further divided into 2 subclasses, Archiclimidae and Metachiclimidae. Archiclimidae include the plants in which petals are free, separate or absent, whereas Metachiclimidae include those plants in which petals are fused. Moving towards the gymnosperms, gymnosperm consists of 7 orders. Among these 7 orders, the 3 of them, Cycadophelicales, Benetetales and Chordates, these consist of species which are extinct now. Psychedels consist of cycads. Ginkgoels consist of ginkgos. Conifers consist of all the conifers, and nettles consists of neetum, which is the most advanced genus. So, outline and basis of classification of Engler and Prandtl system. Engler considered the monocot to be more primitive than the dicot. This is the basic summary of the Engler and Prandtl system of classification, that Engler considered in his system monocots to be more primitive than dicots. Engler and Prandtl system was adopted by American and European countries, but it is not adopted by British countries. Okay, they were following the Bentham and Hooker system or Hutchinson and Bessey system in the light of Hutchinson and Bessey system. So they are not following the Engler and Prandtl system of classification. It is followed in American and European countries, but not in the British. So according to Engler and Prandtl system of classification, the most primitive plants are wind pollinated and most advanced plants are insect pollinated. Both of the scientists gave some characteristics based on the evolutionary relationship, which classify the plants into primitive and advanced orders. Okay, the most primitive plants are believed to be those by Engler and Prandtl which are wind pollinated, and the most advanced plants are considered those which are insect pollinated. Similarly, unisexual plants are more primitive, and with the passage of time, number of sepals and petals are increased. Bisexual flowers are highly advanced flowers. That is, bisexual flower is originated from the unisexual flower. So what is the unisexual flower? Unisexual flower is a flower that possesses either stamens or carpels. It consists of either stamen or either carpels, whereas bisexual flowers are those flowers which possess both stamens and carpels. That is, within the same inflorescence, male and female reproductive parts are present in case of bisexual flowers. So unisexual flowers are those which consists of only stamens or carpels, whereas bisexual flowers are those which consist of both stamens and carpels. That is, within the same inflorescence, male and female reproductive parts are present. So in Engler and Prandtl system, unisexual plants are considered to be more primitive, and with the passage of time, it is said that number of sepals and petals are increased in unisexual plants, whereas bisexual plants are considered to be advanced, and they are thought to be originated from unisexual plants. So next one is free sepals, free petals, free stamens and carpels are the signs of primitive plants, whereas united is the signs of advanced plants. So Engler and Prandtl also describe the primitiveness and advancement of these features, that in the plants which have free sepals, free petals, free stamens and carpels, they are considered more primitive. While in the plants which consists of all these reproductive characters united, this is the sign of advanced plants. So according to Engler and Prandtl system, most primitive plants are wind pollinated and most advanced are insect pollinated. Unisexual plants are thought to be more primitive than the bisexual flowers, and free sepals, petals, stamens and carpels, that is all the reproductive parts which are free, is considered to be the primitive character, whereas the unity of all these characters is considered to be an advanced one. So next one is, if calyx are united, it means that the plant is primitive. If calyx and corolla are united, it means that the plant is advanced. Whereas the union of all parts of flowers represents the most advanced stage. So in Engler and Prandtl system, it is stated that if calyx is united, only if calyx is united in the reproductive part, then these plants are considered to be primitive, these groups. In those groups in which only calyx is united, these groups are thought to be primitive. In those groups in which calyx and corolla both are united, it means that they are advanced. Whereas in all those groups in which all the plants have been united, is considered to be the most advanced stage. Similarly, from various groups of gymnosperms, angiosperms are evolved, monocots and then dicots. From angiosperms, first evolved monocots and then dicots. It means that the dicots are more advanced, whereas monocots are primitive. So in Engler and Prandtl system, it is stated that angiosperms evolved from gymnosperms. Okay, and in angiosperms, first are the monocots to be evolved and then later on the dicot. It means the dicots are more advanced, whereas monocots are primitive. In Engler and Pranter system, it is also stated that gymnosperms are the one which are primitive and they gave rise to angiosperms, or angiosperms evolved from the gymnosperms. In angiosperms, there are two classes, monocots and dicots. So among monocots and dicots, it is reported in this system based on the evolutionary relationships that monocots evolved first and then dicots evolved. It means that monocots are primitive, whereas dicots are advanced in case of angiosperm. So Engler united the polypetali and monoclimadi into a separate group called as archiclimadi, in which dicot plants are included and in which the sepals and petals are free. So Engler and Prandtl in their system also united polypetali, in which petals are fused, and monoclimadi into a separate group, which is archiclimadi, in which dicot plants are included and in which sepals and petals are free. So Engler united polypetali, in which petals are free, and monoclimadi into a separate group, archiclimadi. So archiclimadi consists of both polypetali and monoclimadi. So female flowers evolve from megasporophyll and male from microsporophyll. Female flowers evolve from megasporophyll. What is the megasporophyll? In non-flowering plants, a sporophyll that bears only megasporangia, that is female reproductive spores, female spores. Sporophylls are the leaves on which sporangia are produced, or which bear sporangia. So megasporophyll in female flowers evolve from megasporophyll, while male flowers evolve from microsporophylls. A sporophyll is a leaf that bears the sporangia. Okay, so microsporophyll, which bears male part, and megasporophyll, which bears female part. Monocots have been divided and classified into 11 orders, 45 families, and dicots are divided into 44 orders and 261 families. So in this system of classification, monocots have been divided and classified into 11 orders and 45 families, whereas dicots have been classified into 44 orders and 261 families. So what are the merits and demerits of Engler and Prandtl system of classification? Merits are these: in it's a phylogenetic system, and plant groups are arranged mostly according to their evolutionary affinities, that is their primitiveness and advancement. And this system deals with all the groups of plant kingdom, started from bacteria to that of the angiosperm. This classification also provides the modern taxonomic keys for the identification of each group of plant. And gymnosperms are treated in this classification as a separate group. Its position is before the angiosperm, which is very accurate and is perfect accordance to the modern concept of evolution. And in it, various families are placed, such as the position of Asteraceae as the last family of dicot is very logical and accurate, because it is the highest evolved family among the dicots. Similarly, in this system of classification, anatomical data was taken into consideration. Before that, anatomical data was not taken into consideration in earlier systems of classification. So these are the merits of this system of classification, that it is a phylogenetic system based on evolutionary relationships. This system deals with all group of plants, starting from bacteria to that of the angiosperms. This system provides the modern taxonomic keys, the features on which taxonomic keys should be developed for each group of plants. In this classification system, gymnosperms are treated as a separate group, and it is positioned before the angiosperm, which is very logical, and in modern system of classification, it is the accepted one. Similarly, the Asteraceae is placed as the last family of dicot, and it is very logical. Similarly, anatomical data was taken into consideration in this system, which is a very good criteria of classification of this system. this system. What are the demerits of Engler and Prandtl system of classification? So in Engler and Prandtl system of classification, monocots are considered primitive to dicots, which is not correct according to modern evolutionary evidences, as modern evolutionary evidences did not suggest this, that monocots are more primitive than dicots. Second one is the concept of primitive flower unisexual is against the modern concept of evolution. Okay, third one is combining apetalous families with polypetalous families to form Archiclimedae is not desirable, as it has resulted in the formation of very large group of 33 orders and 206 families. Apetalous mean which don't have petals, and polypetalous which have free petals. So both of these are placed in Archiclimedae, which is not a good classification. And also due to the combination of polypetali and apetali, it will form a larger group which consists of 33 orders and 206 families. So this is also not a very desirable classification, and this system is not of much practical utility, as this is based on evolutionary relationships, and there are certain grouping in this system of classification which is not acceptable today. This is all for Engler and Prandtl system of classification. Thank you.